Today's task is to get a workbench built for the garage. Haven't built one yet, and I really need one. So before I go to the hardware store, kind of did a quick sketch of the table, the workbench. It's not going to be super crazy, 8 feet wide, 3 feet deep, basically plywood top, 2x4 sides, nothing fancy. Then I wrote down all of the size boards that I need, called the shop, figured out which sizes they sell. This is something good to do ahead of time because then you can be efficient. So I figured out I need 4 12 footers and 1 10 footer. This way you don't waste a ton of wood. So I'm going to get this lumber. I need some screws, get the piece of plywood, and we'll get to building. All right, so the first step, I'm going to build the base where the plywood's going to lay. So 2 8-foot sections and a 5 3-foot sections. Shouldn't be too bad. Grab this lumber out, the razors out of here, temporarily put it back together. Grab this wood and we'll get started. All these pieces cut, going to get them laid out on the floor, get everything measured out, make sure it's square, and then zip them all together. All right, so the next step in this is to get everything evenly spaced inside the table. To do this, since I'm putting 3 boards on the inside for bracing, you have 4 empty spaces. So you measure the inside distance. For me, it's the total length is 8 feet, 96 inches, but I have 2 2x4s on either side, so it's going to be 93 inches. You divide that by 4, which comes out to 23 1/4. So you mark out 23 1/4 3 times, and that's exactly where you place the boards. Now, to get them centered, depending on how perfect you want it, I go ahead, measure the board, and mark the center. I did mark one side of the boards. I'm going to mark the other side now. Alright, so now I'm going to cut the legs for the table. Since they didn't have non-treated 4x4s, I'm just going to cut 2 2x4s, screw them together, make a leg for it. Didn't feel like waiting until next week. I had some time today and wanted to get it done. So these will be 44 inches long, and then we'll have the 3/4 inch top, so giving me roughly 45 inch height, kind of like that size. It should be good. Can't wait to get this thing set up because I'm tired of working off the ATV and things like this. I'm actually going to pull this apart and cut these down a little bit. I'm not a big fan of how high this is, so I'll probably drop it down a couple inches at least. So I figured you guys didn't want to watch me build a bunch of those legs. So I have all 4 built. Now I'm going to put them on the table, get everything centered up and straight. Then we'll be able to flip it over and it'll start to look like a table. I'm excited. All right, so all the legs are on this thing finally. I'm going to keep it flipped this way. I'm going to run a board along here, same thing on the other side, and then one along the back here. I'm deciding how high I want that to be. I don't think, because I plan on with that sheet of plywood, when I cut 3 feet off, I'll have a foot left. I'm going to use that foot down here for a shelf for things like my Dremel and all the boxes that are sitting in the corner over there. So they'll have a place to sit down low and out of the way because I really don't use them that often. So kind of deciding how high I want that, I'm thinking I'm going to do about a foot or so off the ground. That way I can still stuff underneath of it, and that should be good. Exactly where I'm going to cut it. It's about a foot in.
basically that gives me enough to cover the table, and I have a little ledge down below. So I'm going to rip it across with the saw. Excuse the funky goggles, but I can't find any safety glasses. So these will have to do. So you 100% do not need to do all that sanding. It's up to you. It's always nice to just have a smooth fit and finish on everything. It makes it look good. So I'm gonna flip this plywood around, get it all centered on there, square it up, screw it in, and then decide where I'm going to put the bottom shelf, and then we'll be done. Trying to figure out where I want that bottom section, because I don't know if I want it all the way in or all the way towards me. I think I'm going to stick with this location because this way I can still have a chair seat like all the way in, be working it there, and the stuff isn't going to get in my way. So I think that's where I'm going to keep it. You know, this could be a better finish and I could notch out those sections and move it all the way to the back, but I'm not really too worried about it. I'm just going to run the last piece of 2x4 I have, probably right in the center here. Just all the way down, screw it in. That way it has something to go up against. And that should be it. Building this really wasn't that difficult. Just took a little bit of time. I think I have about $100 in supplies wrapped up in it, not including any tools that I used. I have another two 2x4x8, and I was going to brace it in the center. But I put my whole body weight on it and I don't feel it flexing. I'll keep those just in case when I load it down, it starts to flex or something, but I might just save those for another project. So you could subtract out a few dollars for that. Maybe you're under $100 for a workbench. It's better than buying one at Home Depot. This way you can build it to your specs, what you want. I know where it's going to go, and just take a look at this area. So excuse the wooden stuff, but I mean, there's just stuff everywhere, stuff all along the edge, all those toolboxes on the ground. So I'm going to get this all cleaned up, and then I'll show you guys what the final look is of it in the garage. So this is the final product. Nothing too crazy, nothing too special, but it's super functional and gives me much more space than this tiny toolbox. So now I have room for all my stuff. It'll be better. I'm also going to build a metal table once my CNC machine shows up. That way I can use my TIG welder and my MIG welder and weld on that and not light this table on fire.